Hello friends, welcome to the Master Camp for SolidWorks tutorial sessions. In this tutorial, we are going to see glimpse of all the operations and additional face milling operation. So we'll see contour milling, then chamfer, then the countersink and drilling, then pocket milling, slot milling. So I have already made the part with the displayed dimensions. The part is 120 in length, 80 in width, and thickness of the part is 25. The four holes, countersink holes, are 12.7 deep with countersink diameter 14 and drill hole diameter 9. Okay, the fillet radius everywhere is 15 millimeters. The slot dimensions are 40 and radius is 6. And this internal pocket, okay, is at offset 20. So let's get directly into the master cam toolpath manager, okay, and go into the tool setting. So I have just given the tool number as 1050. I have used user defined spindle speed value as 4000 rpm, feed rate as 150, then aluminium material I am using, okay, and stock setup, I have just gone into the bounding box. Okay, so I have selected the bounding box in this way. And since we want to execute a face milling operation, so I will increase the Z dimension in the top face, okay, by 5 mm, and that's about it, which we will remove by face milling. So I will say okay over here, and this is the stock. Now the first operation that we will carry out is a face milling. So I'll go to mill tool path and face. The geometry that I will be selecting is a top planar geometry. So I will have to click on this, say select loop. Okay, and the top geometry gets selected. I'll say okay. The 2D toolpath manager opens. Okay, it is facing that we want to do. So the tool that we are going to select is a 50 mm diameter face mill. Okay, 50 mm diameter face mill. Okay, which looks like this along with the holder. So this is one of the largest tools, okay, in whatever we have seen so far, all the contour milling and drilling and pocket and slot milling operation. This is going to be the largest tool with 50 mm diameter. The cut parameters, okay, the style, there are various styles available. I can have a zigzag style. The tool is going to come like this. Okay, there is one way. So tool is going to go in this direction, then again come back, go in this direction, then again come back, go in this direction, and so on. There can be one pass if my workpiece is small and tool is large. And there can be a dynamic motion. So we'll go with one way. Okay, we'll go with one way. The directions, let it be climb. Okay, and I don't want to keep any stock to leave on floors. Okay, we'll give the rough step and finish step properties in such a way that we don't need any stock for the finishing operation later on. So I'll give depth of cuts. The depth of cut, maximum rough step size as 2, maximum finish number of cuts will be 2 with finish step size as 0.5. Okay, and keep the tool down in all these shifts between the rough step and finish step. Okay, then very important thing is linking parameters. So I'll ensure that everything is absolute over here. Depth is a top plane, so my depth right now is going to be 0. My top of stock, I know I have increased it by 5, so it has automatically taken it as 5. We just have to cross check this. We don't have anything to select from. Okay, remember these edges will not be getting selected. Then feed plane, I'll just increase it to 15. Okay, and let the retract be at 25. Okay, I have home and reference position as 250, minus 250, 250. Okay, I will have coolant mistype. Okay, because I have selected aluminium material, so I can have mistype coolant, and that's about it. Okay, I will apply these properties and say okay. Yeah, this is the 2D toolpath that gets generated. Okay, now I'll first save this and I will verify the selected operations. So now if I play this, yeah, I'll just reduce the speed so that we will see. So this is the first direction, then it goes empty, this is the second, then again it goes back empty, then the third. So in three steps it is finishing, and the fourth one, and then again the second iteration in a similar manner. And then the two finishing cycles to follow. Yeah, so that is the first facing operation which we saw. And the next is we'll carry out the contour milling in a known manner. So contour, I will select this as the bottom plane and say okay. We just have to remove these corners of the raw material workpiece, and for that I am going to select a flat end mill of 10 millimeter diameter. Okay, flat end mill of 10 millimeter diameter. So this is the tool. I will have compensation direction as right, and I will give depth of cuts since the 25 is the total depth. So maximum rough steps are going to be say 5. Okay, and finish cuts are not required. Okay, finish cuts are not required. From side we are going to reduce this. Okay. Lead in, lead out, I will say use entry point and adjust the start of contour and end of contour. Now breakthrough I'll switch on because I don't want any burrs on the bottom. So I'll say breakthrough amount is 1 millimeter, and I will have multi passes. Okay, so multi passes to give. So I will say 2 number of rough cuts with spacing equal to 3. And one finish cut with spacing equal to 0.5. Okay, now these numbers can adjust themselves. Okay, and we will get optimum number of we will get at least some number of rough cuts and at least one number of finish cut. Okay, so that is the idea. Linking parameters. Okay, I will select the depth like this. Then top of stock I will select from here, which is ideally 0. Feed plane let it be 10 and retract let it be 25. Okay, home reference position is what we are selecting is machine default, that is x250y minus 250 z250. Okay, the coolant I can go ahead with mistype coolant since the material is aluminium, and that's about it for the contour milling. I'll say okay. Yeah, and as you can see, this is a contour milling that get carried out. I'll just save the part for the safety, and carefully I will load the verify selected operations. I will select all operations and then I will click on verify selected operations. So once it gets loaded, it's better to wait for a while. Yeah, let it completely load and then we can work with it. Okay, so this is the part. I'll just run the first operation very quickly. then the change of tool happens. This is the second operation that gets carried out, and the corners are getting removed. Okay, corners are getting removed. So that's about the second operation, that is the contour milling or side milling, we can call it. Then we'll go ahead and carry out the drilling operation. Okay, so drilling can be carried out in two stages. So first there will be normal drill. Okay, first there will be normal drill. And then there will be chamfer drill. So I'll select the library tool. Select the drill. And I want 9 mm as the diameter. So I'll select the HSS high speed steel 9 mm diameter drill. Okay, this is the tool. Okay, the depth is not much, okay, 12.37 or something. So I'll directly go to linking parameters. Okay, I'll first select the depth. This is the depth of the drilled hole, so it is minus 12.7. Top of stock is 0. Okay, let the retract distance be 10. Okay, let the retract distance be 10. Okay, we don't want to switch on tip compensation because these are not through holes. Okay, let the home reference position be constant, that is the default. Coolant, let it be flood type coolant, and yeah, that's about it. So I'll say apply and okay, and as you can see the drill toolpath is also appeared, okay, for four holes. I will again just save the part, okay, select all the operations, and then I will verify the selected operation. Let the entire part load first. Okay, it's loaded, and then I will run the operations. This is the first, that is face milling. Then I have the contour milling, and then the drilling operation of the specified depth. Okay, so okay, now we'll do the pocket operation. We'll do this countersink operation slightly later. So first we'll do this pocket. I'll select the loop. Yeah, this is correct. Pocket. The tool I will be selecting is the 16 millimeter end mill with radius 16 and corner radius as 0.5. So this is the tool. The cut parameters, it is going to be climb. I don't want to leave any stocks on the walls and floors. Okay, and tip compensation is going to be tip. Okay, roughing, I am going to go with constant overlap spiral, and entry motion is going to be helix with plunge angle as 3 degrees. Okay, and finishing, I will have two passes of 0.5 each. I will keep the tool down, and lead in lead out is going to be use entry point and use exit point. We'll specify depth of cuts. Since I have to achieve 15, so I will go with 4 rough steps, that is maximum rough step size 4. I will have 2 finish cuts, with finish cut step as 0.5. I will keep the tool down. I don't want breakthrough. I will go with linking parameter values, that is absolute everywhere. Depth I will select as minus 15. Then top of stock I will select as this 0. Feed plane and retract plane. Okay, then home reference position is going to be remaining default. And coolant, I can switch on the mistype coolant. I will just say apply. Okay. Yeah, this is the pocket operation. Let us just verify. So first I'll save this. I'll select all. Then I'll verify selected operations. This is the first face milling, then the side, that is contour milling. Then I have the drilling operation and then the pocket milling operation. Then I have the second operation, that is the slot milling. So I'll go to contour and I'll select this tool path for slot. That's okay. I'll select slot mill. Now since the radius is 6 for the slot, okay, I will go with the smallest tool, that is 3 mm diameter, having 0.2 as the corner radius. The tool looks like this. Okay, the cut parameters, okay, tip compensation, then the stock to leave on walls and floors I will not require. Okay, perpendicular entry. A rough step, the plunge angle is going to be 3, step over is 50%, that is 1.5, and number of finishing passes I will say 2 with 0.25 mm each, and I will keep the tool down. Depth of cuts I will initiate, so say maximum rough step is of 2, finish cuts will be 2 of 0.5 each, and I will keep the tool down. A breakthrough again is not necessary. Linking parameters I will select carefully, everywhere let it be absolute, and depth is going to be a minus 15, and top of stock will change. Now top of stock is going to be this, it is minus 10, and feed plane let it be 10, and retract let it be 25. Home reference position is default. I will just check the coolant. Yeah, that is mistype. So I'll just say apply. I'll say okay. So now I have the slot operation as well. Okay, so I'll just select all. Before that, I will save. Select all and verify selected operations. Right from the start again, second operation, deep drilling, then I have pocket milling, and then the slot milling. So now only one operation remaining, that is the countersink operation. So for that I will again select the drilling operation. I'll select these holes. Yeah. normally drilling. Select the tool as the countersink tool, that is 16.5 mm. Now since the tool library is not that much extensive, so we don't have all possible tools available in this tool library, because this is MasterCAM's student version. And this is what the tool looks like. In the linking parameters, I am going to specify depth by giving the value as -7.5. The top of stock I am going to specify from here, which is 0. Okay, retract I will specify as 10. Okay, I will not require the clearance and etc. Tip compensation again not required. Home position is going to be default. Coolant I will switch on the flood type coolant. Just say OK. And yeah, check the box, save this, and select all the operations and verify selected operations. This is the first operation. In the second operation, contour milling. In the drilling, then I have the pocket milling. In the slot milling, and then then the countersinking. So yeah, we have covered all the operations. Now so it gets time sometimes to enhance the model. As you can see, it keeps on updating itself, so it can take some time, but we have finished all the operations, and I hope you have understood how to apply all these operations on the MasterCAM for SolidWorks environment. So hope to see you next time with more such interesting content on the CAM tutorials, that is for MasterCAM for SolidWorks software. Thank you very much.